did you do that?
I feel bad because I didn't.
Okay.
Next time I'll get you a clock.
At this time, I would like to call to order the June 27th regular meeting of the Little Miami Local Schools Board of Education. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Grace?
Here.
Mr. Kamini?
Here.
Mr. Neiman? Absent. Mrs. Janae?
Here.
Mr. Haas? Absent.
Would you please stand and join us for the pledge of the flag?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, at this time, I would like a motion to adopt the agenda as written plus the addendums to the agenda.
I'll move.
Okay, any questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Kamini?
Yes.
Mrs. Janae?
Yeah.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
No, we have to talk.
Okay, item number five, I would like a motion to accept the reading of the minutes for the May 18th regular meeting and May 23rd regular meeting.
I'll move. I'll second.
Any questions? May we have a roll call, please?
Mrs. Janae?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kamini?
Yes. Item six, I would like a motion for the reading of the minutes on June 5th, special meeting.
I'll move. I'll second.
Any questions? Roll call.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kamini?
Yes.
Mrs. Janae?
Yes.
Okay, item number seven, I would like a motion for the meeting, to approve the meeting of, reading of the minutes for the June 19th emergency meeting, and I'll move.
I'll second.
Okay, at this time, we will have a roll call.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kamini?
Yes.
Mrs. Janae?
Okay, at this time, we will have communications and/or visitors to the board.
Hi there.
Hi there.
Welcome back. Back from a 5,700-mile road trip.
Good for you.
All of what he's done.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I think my wife was ready for a break. Basically, 3 days out and 3 days back, so, you know, that's a lot of road time in a car with me. So, I did share with the board in the communication yesterday, Christy Boron, our consultant, had done an assessment of Salem to look at what we would need to invest over the next 10 years or so into Salem to keep it online. So she kind of broke things down into what we would more immediately need to do, invest, and then into phase 1B and 2, what we would need to invest. So up front, there's probably initially about $1 million that we would need to invest in Salem to keep it online, to take us out another 4 or 5 years. And then when we became eligible for an OSCC project with phase 1B, basically another $900,000 or so that we would need to invest to take it through to where we would complete the construction of the preschool, kindergarten building, and first grade building that's behind it. And then we can take that offline. I also have an enrollment update for you tonight. We keep enrolling students. It's a nice problem to have. Right now, as of this morning, in the online enrollment program that we have 18 appointments that are for enrollment and another 15 that are in the process of starting, and I think even since I talked to Nancy this morning, there are even more for assessing it. Right now, at this point, we do have at fifth and sixth grade, we're at that point where we need to add another fifth and sixth grade teacher. So we had done some preliminary posting for those positions, so we have a screening process done on those, anticipating that the continue. So we're going to be seeking to hire another fitness grade for the intermediate building for the fall. Yeah, we're right at 30 to 1.
So do you have to do that before a certain date or?
We're okay as far as, we're in good shape on that. And it does appear in talking to Nancy that a lot of people are coming back from private school.
Oh, good.
So some of this is new movements, but it's private school kids returning to our school district. That's where we are right now, and that's my update.
Thank you, sir. Okay, at this time, we will have community comments on agenda items. Mrs. Coates?
No one has signed up.
Okay. At this time, we will have treasurer's reports and recommendations, or, yeah, and also a one on the agenda.
All right, under letter A, I'm asking for the board's approval of the financial reports for the month ending May 2017.
I'll move.
I'll second.
Any questions?
Includes our bank reconciliation, our fund balance report for all individual funds, and also two different budget reports, any revenue report from the general fund.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mr. Kameens?
Yes.
Mrs. Jurnett?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Next, under item B, I ask for the board's approval of the two contracts listed.
I'll move.
I'll second.
The two contracts listed, one is with Ohio School Board Association, that's for updates for online board policies. You can obtain them, all those off the internet, on the web. And then the second contract is with Ignition, with an certified athletic trainer who provided for our high school facilities. And that will actually be paid out of funds from Mercy, for their proceeds. So there are no costs to the district, it's new revenue, which we're using for.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Jurnett?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kameens?
Yes.
Next, under item C, I ask for the board's approval of the amended appropriations for the current year fiscal year 17.
I'll move.
Second.
And you can see the handout front, it's a permanent appropriation listed by each individual fund, and those are our overall what's appropriate to spend for the current fiscal year.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kameens?
Yes.
Mrs. Jurnett?
Yes.
Next, under item E, or excuse me, D, I'm asking for approval of temporary appropriations for the upcoming fiscal year 2018, which is, of course, July 1, 17 to June 30th, 2018.
I'll second.
Any questions?
Yeah, once again, they're noted by fund, individual fund. And these are temporary, will be coming back, of course, during the first couple months of new fiscal year with permanent appropriations.
Roll call.
Mr. Kameens?
Yes.
Mrs. Jurnett?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Thank you. Next, under item E, I ask for the board's approval of the fiscal year 18 and 19 exempted employee handbook.
I'll move.
I'll second.
As you can see in your copy, there's some highlighted sections that were, any changes that were made were actually highlighted in different colors, whether it was additional or taken out in green. And then, of course, the pay scales were updated in the back of the handbook.
All right. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Jurnett?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Kameens?
Yes.
Next, item F, I ask for your board's approval of a special needs resolution. Nancy?
Nancy's looking.
Once again, this is actually, we passed a resolution in May for special needs, and we actually changed our dollar amount, that's why we're updating this one. I did get a handout, you had one in your packet, I gave you a handout because it actually has an extra set at the end of section 6, it says it rescinded to the other one, other than that, the exact same document. But we added additional $600,000, and this will go to the HUD Department of Education and the HUD Department of Taxation with other, two other documents to get our special needs approver, so we can get on the ballot in November of 2017 for construction.
Okay. Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
Thank you. And then last, ask for the board's approval, item G, and this is the amended certificate of estimated resources for the current year of fiscal year 2017.
I'll move.
Second.
Once again, this is a list of our, what I'm estimating our VR resources coming for this current fiscal year 2017, but broken out each individual template, or excuse me, each individual fund.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace? Thank you. And that's all I have, thank you.
Thank you, Terry. Okay, at this time, we will have the superintendent's reports and recommendations. Mr. Powell, please.
I'd like to ask the board's approval for all the items listed under item A, personnel.
I'll move. Second.
Any questions? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
And I do think we have a couple of new staff here tonight. Would you come up and introduce yourself to our board?
Hi, thank you. Hi, nice to meet you, Sarah.
Hi, I'm Sally.
Hi.
Sally?
Yes.
Hello.
Kindergarten.
Kindergarten?
Yes. Hi, nice to meet you.
Hi. How are you?
Hello. Thanks, nice to meet you.
Roll call, please. Do we already have roll call? Yes, we do. Okay.
And then item B, ask the board's approval for the 2018-19 school calendar. Recommending draft one, which has spring break at the end of third quarter.
Okay.
Easter falls on April 21st, which is very late that year. Leaves us with just 4 weeks of school after that spring break out there at the.
And when is that again, sir?
Yes, the Easter falls on April the 21st in the 18-19 school year, which leaves us with just 4 weeks of school left.
Okay.
And it's also in the middle of the state testing window, even though the state hasn't put those testing dates out yet. We anticipate that that's going to be in the middle of that testing window.
So that's why we have to change, right?
Okay.
I'll second.
Roll call.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
I'd ask the board's approval for the 2017-18 building handbooks for the high school, the Miami Junior High, and the K-4 elementary.
I'll move.
Second. Any questions, ladies?
No.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
I'd ask the board's approval for item D, resolution 17-009 of the OESAA resolution of participation.
I'll move.
Second.
This is an annual resolution that we pass as a part of our athletic participation in the state framework.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Dragg?
Yes.
Mrs. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Cremings?
Yes.
Thank you, that's all I got.
Thank you, sir. Okay, good business. One-time person report.
Okay, we have training on board docs at the very beginning of our meeting last time. It was quite interesting. We will probably have to have retraining 3 or 4 times. I went home with my computer and set it up and didn't work as well as it did when we were there. So we're all gonna go back
There's lunch coming up.
Yes, we're going to take the secretary to lunch. She's going to go over it again. We also approved multiple agreements and contracts and memorandums of understanding, just like we do here. We also approved a proposal for Concord Construction to renovate our veterinary science lab. We had it at the animal shelter, and they needed more room, so we had to move. Board approved resolution authorizing the district to purchase food and refreshments at district meetings and community events. At one time, we were not allowed to do that. The state has now come down, so you know, as long as it's approved by the board, like if you have a parents in for a breakfast or something, we can use our money to do that. We approved stipends for 22 district employees because of personal cell phones. They've been using them, so we're going to let them use their personal and just give them a stipend. We accepted donations. One of them was a 2005 Mazda Automotive Tech. This lets our kids work on cars and get practice. We also have a student achievement report, and we talked about two adults and two high school students who received our. We have an educational foundation at the Career Center, and so we do it mostly for things for the kids. So they got scholarships this year. And then upcoming events, Warren County Fair is July 17th through the 2nd, and we usually have a booth there. And our adult education open house is August 2nd from 3 to 7. They really have some really neat things for adults to take up there, so if you're ever interested, you might check out their calendar. In fact, the calendar came out, I think, last week. And superintendent presented data. This is our first board meeting with our new superintendent, Mr. Rick Smith. And he presented data on enrollment history, and he does market share, so he kind of gives some information on, you know, where we were, where we are now, and where we want to be. So it was really interesting. And that's all I have.
Thank you, Mrs. Grice. Okay, our next board meeting will be Tuesday, July 25th at 7 o'clock at the Little Miami High School Media Center. So, be there, be square. Okay. Any objection? Any objection? I need a motion. Mrs. Coates?
No.
No one. All right, now I need a motion to go into executive session. It is to consider the sale of public property. I'm going to repeat the action taken this evening.
No.
I'll second.
Hey, thanks for coming, y'all.
This is a fastest board meeting.